She swept the covers back and stood. No sounds. Surely she'd imagined it. She would just go check on the girls. It would calm her. She reached for her robe and in the darkness found the armholes. Her ears sharp for any tick of a floorboard or click of a latch, she crept to the door. The doorknob was a cool ball in her palm. She turned it slowly. The door came free, and she drew it in an inch. An eye to the crack showed her a stretch of the hallway in the pale glow of a nightlight. And no one there. She drew the door inward further. The nightlight illuminated the swell of her gown before her, where her robe only barely reached across her stomach. Again, she found herself holding her breath as she leaned forward to look out. She wanted to believe she'd imagined it, but beating down her instincts didn't work. Not this time. Something was wrong. She entered the hallway. In three paces, she was at the door to Stephanie's room. After a glance to either side, she turned the knob. The glow of the hallway nightlight widened into the room. She looked to Stephanie's bed. The girl slept. And with Stephanie's arm draped over her back, Natalie lay sleeping next to her. Jennifer breathed. She stepped around the cot. Natalie lay with her eyes closed, that dimple in her brow lit dimly by the hallway nightlight, something in her dream worth her concentration. It made Jennifer smile. Reaching down and forward to adjust the blanket was a trial of balance and strength, but Jennifer had to touch her. She brought the blanket up over Natalie's shoulder, and the nightlight lit Natalie's face, her brows rising slightly in recognition of a shift in her sleepy environment. Then a shadow blocked the light from the hallway. Jennifer's breath caught. She pushed up from the bed and began to turn. It would be Ed or Kristen. It had to be. Jennifer faced the doorway. It wasn't Ed. It wasn't Kristen. A man filled the doorway. A man too big and thick to be Ed. Jennifer worked to take a halting breath. She shifted her feet. The bulky silhouette took a half step inside, and the black block of his head rotated to the left and to the right, as if he were taking in the occupants of the room. Jennifer shielded her daughter. Her hands wanted a weapon, but nothing was in reach. Another shadow appeared behind the man. Another man. Nearly 9 months pregnant, her due date only days away, and what could she do against these two men? Shouting would only wake the girls and Kristen, and if they became witnesses, their chances of survival plummeted. Jennifer drew back her shoulders, pulled her robe around her as far as it would go. She held her head high and stepped toward the men.